Hi, I'm Julie from Indigo Handmade Design. Welcome to my channel. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to crochet this maxi skirt. So let's get into it. This skirt is a size medium. Here are my measurements. So go ahead and measure between your waistline and your hips. And we are going to make two panels. We are going to start right here at the top of the skirt, and we are first going to work single crochet rows until we reach the measurement, and then we are going to go with double crochet rows. Okay, so here is where we are going to start. Take your 4mm hook, make a slip knot, and then chain 6. In the second chain from the hook, make a single crochet, and then one single crochet in each chain left, so you are going to have a total of 5 single crochets. Now go ahead and chain 1 and turn your work. This doesn't count as a stitch, this is your turning chain. Make one single crochet in your first 2 stitches. And then in your third stitch, we are going to single crochet 3 in the same stitch. So we are going to increase our work. So 3 single crochets in the same stitch. Now go ahead and take your stitch marker and mark your second increase. So you had 3, the middle one. In this stitch right here, we are going to increase all the way down our panel. And now take again your hook and make one single crochet in your remaining 2 stitches. This is what you have for now. Chain 1, turn your work, and now we are also going to start increasing at the beginning and also at the end of our panel. So make in your very first stitch 2 single crochets. So at the beginning and at the end of the row, you are going to increase with 2. Now 1 single crochet in your next 2 stitches, and right here where your stitch marker is, you are going to increase with 3. So you are going to make 3 single crochets all worked in the same stitch. So basically we are increasing with 4 stitches in each row. Place again your stitch marker in the middle like so, so in your second single crochet. Now make 1 single crochet in your next 2 stitches. And right here we are also going to make 1 increase, so work 2 single crochets in your last stitch. Okay, now to start your next row, you are going to chain 1, turn your work, and start with 1 increase, so 2 single crochets worked in the same stitch. Now you are going to make 1 single crochet in each stitch till you reach your stitch marker. And now take your stitch marker off and make your middle increase. So in the middle, you are always going to make 3 single crochets all worked in the same stitch. Place again your stitch marker in there, so in your second increase. And then make one single crochet in each stitch till you have one stitch left, so your last stitch. And again in there you are going to make your increase, which is two single crochets worked in the same stitch. And this is how you are going to work with your first color, for a total of 7 single crochet rows. So I've worked all this portion here in single crochet till I reached my measurement. So I've also changed color only on the back side of my panel. So I've worked 7 yellow single crochet rows, 2 dark blue, 8 light green, 6 pink, and 2 single crochet with a black until I've reached again my measurement, so which is a 43 centimeter on each panel. And then I've started working in double crochet rows. But first let me show you how to change color. Okay, now to change color, so we are always going to change our color on the right side of the work. So go ahead and make a slip knot and then cut your yarn and pull through. Turn your work, so now you are on the right side of your work. Take your next color, in my case this is dark blue. Make a slip knot and join to your very first stitch with a single crochet, and this is also going to be your first single crochet. And now in the same stitch make another single crochet, so you are starting with one increase, and then just work one single crochet in each stitch till you reach your stitch marker, and then in there go ahead and make your middle increase and work on the other side after that and finish with one increase again. Okay, so I'm going to work my remaining single crochet rows off camera, and then I'll meet you back once I have this done to show you how to work your remaining rows, so your double crochet rows, until you reach the length of your panel. Okay, so once you have your single crochet rows done, I'm going to take my gray color, make a slip knot, and then join to my very first stitch, so right here. Now we are going to start working in double crochet rows, so join with a slip stitch and then chain 3. This counts as your first double crochet. And now from now on we are going to increase only in the middle of our panel, so we are increasing with 2 stitches in each row, in each increase row. So go ahead now and make one single crochet in each stitch until you reach your increase, so where your stitch marker is. Okay, so this is the stitch where you are going to make again your increase in the middle. So for this you are just going to work 3 double crochets in the same stitch, so the same as you've made with your single crochets, and then make 1 double crochet in each stitch across till the end of the row. And I'll meet you back at the end to show you how to work your next row. So if you need to go ahead and place a stitch marker
Again, there where you are going to keep increasing in each row. So each row we are increasing with 2 stitches when you work this row. Now the next row, it's a little bit different. So we are going to start with 1 decrease and end with 1 decrease, which means the next row we are keeping the same stitch count. So you are going to chain 2 because we are starting with a decrease, and then just make 1 double crochet in the next stitch, and this is your decrease. Now if you want, you can place a stitch marker in there so that you know this is in the next row, this is going to be the last stitch you want to crochet. Now you are going to make 1 double crochet in each double crochet till you meet your next stitch marker where you are going to make your increase. So 3 double crochets worked all in the same stitch, and then go back on the other side, make 1 double crochet in each double crochet till you have 2 stitches left. So this one and your 3 chain, these are your last 2 stitches, and here you are going to decrease. So I'm going to work this row off camera and then just meet you back to show you how to make your decrease. Okay, so I have these 2 stitches left. Now you are going to yarn over and double crochet 2 stitches together. So 1 unfinished, then go in your 3rd chain. You have 3 loops on your hook. Go ahead and close all of your 3 loops. Now you are going to chain 3, turn your work, this is your 1st double crochet, and then just work 1 double crochet in each stitch across till you meet your stitch marker. In here you are going to make your increase and then go back on the other side and do the same. Now let me take a look on my cheat sheet right here. Okay, and by alternating these 2 rows, you are going to, so each other row you are going to increase your work with 2 stitches. So when you are making this row right here with chain 3 and end with 1 double crochet in the last stitch, you are increasing your work. Okay, now my panel measures 70 centimeters, so it is wide 70 centimeters. Now this is for me enough. My skirt, it's a size medium, but if you want to have more drape, you are just going to alternate these 2 rows for as long as you want. Now in my case, I've worked 6 rows with my gray color. By alternating these 2 rows, then I've worked 2 rows with the mustard color, and then I've started with my dark blue, and then I've worked 1 row no decrease, 1 row decrease, 1 row no decrease, and then from here I've changed a little bit. So I've worked 3 rows by decreasing at the beginning and at the end of the row, of each row, so 3 rows, and then I've changed color to black and worked 2 rows with black. I've made 1 row no decrease, 1 row with decrease. So when you start and end your row with no decrease, this means you are increasing your stitches with 2, and then I've worked, and then from here I've just decreased in each row, so my stitch count stay the same through entire work, so till I finished my panel. So I have 6 rows with off-white, 2 rows with lime, 8 rows with light blue, 4 rows with pink, 2 rows with light green, 2 rows with red, and then 1 row with purple. So I'm going to work all of these rows off camera, and then I'll meet you back here to show you how to finish your panel so that your skirt is going to be straight at the bottom. Since when we are working like this, we are increasing in the middle, so you are going to have this triangular shape. Okay, I'm going to meet you back here. And I also want to mention that my panel is 80 centimeters long, so if I am not very tall, so if you are tall, go ahead and work more rows. And if you want your skirt to be wider, so to have more drape, go ahead and increase more.
Okay, so I've reached the length of my panel, so I've worked one row with purple. Now we are going to start working separately on the side. So for this, go ahead and chain two and double crochet in the next stitch. So this is your first decrease right here. Now make one double crochet in each stitch until you reach the middle of the dress of your panel. So right here are your three double crochets, so where you've increased right here. So you are going to leave the middle one undone and then count three stitches back. So there is where we are going to decrease again. So work till you have these three stitches left, like so. Now on the side we are only decreasing two, and in the middle of the panel we are going to decrease three stitches together. So make three unfinished double crochets. So this is the first double crochet from your increase, right? Now go ahead and close all of your loops. Now when you are turning your work, you are also going to start decreasing three stitches. You are on the inside of the panel, and on the outside you are going to decrease only two stitches. Now go ahead and chain two, turn your work, and make two unfinished double crochets in your next two stitches. So not this one, but this one is your next stitch. So you have here one unfinished double crochet, and now make another one in the next stitch. Three loops on your hook, go ahead and close all of your three loops, and now make one double crochet in each stitch till you have two stitches left, and then you are going to make your side decrease. So again, on the outside of the panel you are decreasing two stitches, on the inside you are decreasing three stitches. Now go ahead and work like this. So I have a total of three purple, two grays, two greens, two mustard, two black, and then seven rows with off white. And then once you have your sixth row done with your off white, you are going to decrease all of your stitches together in your seventh row, then chain one and cut your yarn. and then start working on the other side of the panel. So you are going to reattach in the middle of your panel and start working a 3 stitches decrease, and then again work your 3 rows, purple, 2 grays, 2 greens, 2 mustard, 2 black, and 7 of white. And in your last row you are going to decrease all of your stitches. Now go ahead and make 2 panels for your maxi dress and a maxi skirt, and this leftover yarn, so you have here all these tails. You are going to use this later on to make your side seaming. So I'm going to do all this work off camera, and then I'll meet you back again to show you how to finish your skirt. So once you have finished your skirt, here is my side seam. Now I am on the bottom of my skirt. Go ahead and take which color you want. I'm taking dark blue. Now we are going to work 1 row of single crochet. So reattach your yarn with a single crochet. This is your first stitch, and we have only double crochet row. So this means we are going to place 2 single crochets in each double crochet row. So go ahead and work all the way around, and once you're at the end of the round, you are just going to slip stitch to your very first stitch, chain one, cut your yarn, and weave in your loose end.
Okay, now once you've made the bottom of your maxi skirt, we are now going to work on the waistline, and for this we are going to start on the side. So you are on the right side of your work, and for this one you are going to work with your 3 millimeter crochet hook. And first we are going to work all around one round of single crochet. So go ahead in your first row, which is a single crochet row, and make 1 single crochet, like so. So in each single crochet row you are going to make 1 single crochet. Okay, so I'm going to work off camera all around, and then I'll meet you back. I forgot to mention, once you are right here in the middle where you started your panel, you are just going to single crochet in each stitch, okay? Now I am at the end of the round. Now I am going to slip stitch to my very first single crochet, like so, and go ahead and chain 6. And now you are going to single crochet in the second chain from the hook. We are going to make the ribbing, so we are going to have a total of 5 single crochets. So 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now go in the next stitch and make 1 slip stitch, and in the next 1 slip stitch. And now we are going to work back, and for this go ahead and turn your work and we are going to work in the back loop only. So for this you are going to skip your first 2 stitches, and then in the next work 1 single crochet in the back loop only. So you are going to have again a total of 5 single crochets in the back loop only. So 3, 4, and 5. Now the last one I'm going to work a usual single crochet. So you can work your last stitch in the only in the back loop if you like so, but I like to make my last stitch just a usual single crochet. So this is the fifth single crochet. Now for the next row, you are going to chain one, turn your work, and again, instead of working in the back loop only, I'm going to make my first stitch a usual single crochet. So this is the first single crochet, and then I'm going to work in the back loop only. 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then slip stitch the next two stitches. So 1 and 2. Turn your work, skip your first two stitches, these two, and then work your single crochets in the back loop only. So this is how you are going to work all around your skirt to make the ribbing. And then once you have this done, you can either make a drawstring and put a drawstring all around your waistline, or you can put a thin elastic band all around.
I'm now at the end of my tutorial. Thank you all for watching and for joining me today, and I see you soon with a new one. Bye bye.